Right, welcome back everybody to Let's Play Skyrim. It is the following morning from whence we last spoke, dear viewers. We've slept. We haven't eaten yet, actually. I forgot to eat some breakfast. I'm apparently hungry, thirsty. Yeah, we'll deal with that in a minute. I've been to the shops, sold some junk. Not very much. I got rid of my mace and my short spear because I realised I have a much better weapon than either of them. I have this, which General Tullius gave us, along with our promotion to the office of Questor, which is pretty awesome. I'm kind of annoyed, well, not annoyed, but a little bit disappointed they didn't keep the old ranks, the old Legion ranks from, from Morrowind. You know, like Knight of the Imperial Dragon and, you know, that kind of thing, but never mind. Never mind. Yeah, Lydia's here, and yeah, the only things I need haven't done yet is, well, yeah, I haven't eaten anything for breakfast or drunk anything, which I'll do before we leave, but I also haven't bought any potions. I want to get into the habit of visiting the potion shop every time I visit a city to make sure I always have some potions, since I'm not currently in the practice of making them myself.
You're a traveller, correct? Have you been to a white run?
yeah. Actually, yes.
Wonderful. I hadn't really hoped to run into someone who'd been there. My daughter Fura was assigned to white run after she joined the Imperial Army. I was hoping you might have met her. I haven't heard from her lately. I've tried talking to Captain Aldous, but he hasn't been any help.
Oh dear. I haven't met her, but I could try to get some more information for you, madam, if you wish.
Oh, that's very sweet of you. Anything you can find out from Captain Aldous would be welcome news.
Right, yes.
So you're interested in my potions and ingredients?
Well, the potions, yes. What have you got for me? Aha! Excellent, lots of health potions. Expensive, but worth it, I think. So we've got loads of gold to flash around, so... Regenerate health fortification, nah, sort those, we don't need them. Stamina, maybe? Nah, I think we'll manage. Health potions are the main thing.
Next time you need herbs.
So now we've got... Yeah, 21 health, small health potions, 10 medium ones, 2 larger ones. Good. Excellent. That's. I feel safe now, if you know what I mean. Right, so Captain Aldous, if memory serves, is... He's actually the captain of the guard here in Solitude, isn't he? I'm almost tempted to go off to Shadow Green Cavern again and find Noster's helmet, but I think Claudius probably would have forgotten about that entirely by now. I like this, by the way. I like that now we've got. I like having this extra freedom to kind of just run off and do whatever. The last few episodes have felt a bit like, oh god, I've got to go here, and I've got to go back there, and I've got to do this and that, because oh my god, I've got to stay in character, and it's the story and stuff. You know, gotta run to Windhelm, then run back to Whiterun to warn everyone, and... Eh, you know. I will be honest, Lydia. It's nice to not have any responsibilities for the moment. Other than to get myself up to High Hrothgar. Yeah, this is Captain Aldous, I thought so.
You see those warriors from Hammerfell? They've got curved swords. Curved swords.
I know, it's outlandish, isn't it? Ugh, would you believe some people thought I was skilled with curved swords? What nonsense, eh? Anyway, are you with the Legion, technically speaking?
That I am. Train the recruits. Turn boys into men. That sort of thing. Thinking of asking the General for some training books. Give the soldiers something to do while they're on rest. Something besides drinking. Hmm. Ever seen a book called The Mirror? We used to hand it out to boys looking to learn basic shield work.
Nope, but if I do find a copy, I'll hand it over.
Good on you.
So, yeah. Angela sent me to ask about her daughter.
Not my finest hour.
Whoops! Oh, for God's sake, stupid Rog dialogue
here
thing.
Was a fine and honourable man.
Was he? Didn't seem that fine and honourable to me. I think I might prod him a little bit now, fix him with a bit of a accusing stare and be like, so you think what he did was right, hmm?
No, I think he was entirely wrong.
Exactly.
Rogier's execution was justified and necessary.
Precisely.
Being honourable might make you a good man, but it doesn't make you right. Be a better world if it did.
Fair enough. So anyway, yeah, about this woman's daughter.
Generally posting information is need to know only.
Oh, nice, that's cool. I never knew about that. Ha! Extra dialogue option because I'm part of the Legion. Sweet. But tell me about her daughter. That's an order, Captain.
Yes, sir. Although I'm not sure you'll be happy to know. The daughter was sent to Whiterun. The skirmishes there have been violent. The Whiterun Legate, he needed to know the Stormcloak positions. He sent out a party to scout the area. They happened upon a large force. I'm told none of them made it back. Private Morard, Angela's daughter, was in that scouting party. She needs to be told. Concentrate. The battlefield is full of distractions. Ignore them. Focus on your targets.
Oh dear, Lydia. I suppose we better go deliver the bad news. Oof. That's depressing.
Heard they're reforming the Dawn Guard. Vampire hunters or something. In the old fort near Riften. Might consider joining up myself.
No, no you don't, because you're needed here. Thanks very much. That's what I told the Dawnguard man himself.
Got something for just about everybody in here. Give a holler if you have any questions.
Oh God, she's so cheerful. This is going to suck.
It's good to see a fresh face. You wouldn't have happened to come from Whiterun, would you?
Bless, she doesn't have that great a memory, does she, though? I have some news about your daughter.
You got Aldous to tell you something. I knew you would. What did he say?
Yeah.
I told her. I told her the Imperial Army would kill her. That this was a war of Jarls and Imperial Generals, and we had no part in it. She just wouldn't hear it. It was brave of you to come to me with this. I can't thank you for it, not for this. But you have done me a service.
It's going to be one of those days, isn't it, Lydia? Let's just go. Actually, no, let's go eat some breakfast. Because I've still not had any breakfast. Because I completely forgot. I don't even have any food on me. I'm going to have to go buy some from the bartender.
Welcome to the Winking Skeever, friend.
What have you got for sale?
Take a look.
Right. Steamed mud crab legs. God, I bet they're tasty, actually. Tomato soup. Yeah, why not? A jug of milk, wow. You know, I'm having that. I'm taking a jug of milk with me, definitely. A boiled egg. Fair enough. It's good.
Remember
breakfasty
the
food.
Skeever next time your foot's up.
Okie doke, so I've got some boiled water, a whole boatload of empty bottles. Shall I drink an entire jug of milk? I don't know, I've got tomato soup and the boiled egg. I'm full, good, and yeah, screw it, the entire jug, why not? Thirst has been well and truly quenched. Excellent. Once the dragon sought to eliminate... Oh, never mind. We'll find out what that loading screen said another time. Right, okay, let's get kitted up. Helmet, shield, backpack. I still need to make Lydia a backpack. Ugh, never mind, I can't be bothered now. And let's go. And you know what, I'm going to wander down to the farm just so I can get the stables marked on my map, because that was really annoying earlier. Not having them on there to fast travel to. Right. Bit of a miserable looking day, innit? Never mind. Lovely new longsword. Oh, can't wait to try this out.
Tools, wares, and weapons. All for sale at fair prices.
Hello again, Madram.
Take a look.
Okay. What have I... I don't think I've got anything I can really sell them, have I? Because I already sold all the stuff I could sell to the people in town. So what has he got? Oh, he's got my ebony dragon claw. Hang on a minute. I've got a gold dragon claw. Except I can't sell it because... quest item. Never mind. Hang on a minute. Ladu, do you still have those dragon bones, or did I sell those?
Right behind you. I am at your command.
Aha! You do still have some of them. Good. Well, those... Yeah, anyway.
You lead, I'll follow.
The longer we take a look.
There we go. Excellent. That was, yeah, a fair bit of gold.
Come to do business with us again.
Right, let's go. I feel completely warm, apparently. What is the weather like in the minute? The air is pleasant. Am I still... Yeah, mod still seems to think I'm drunk. I might have to restart that, actually. You know what? Why not? I'll do it now. Right, except I'll cut it out just to keep the immersion going or whatever. Right. Deactivated, reactivate the mod. Seems to be working perfectly now. Lovely. Good.
Need a ride?
Yep. Well, do I? I need to go get this stupid map marker unlocked first. But where do I need to actually go? I suppose back to Whiterun, I guess, and then I need to march off towards Ivarstead. Right, there we go. Catalyst farm discovered. Good. I think. Let's see, Gazira, we need to get to Ivarstead first. So, I mean, we could go to Riften and then travel along that way, but I don't think it would be any shorter, honestly. If we go back to Whiterun and then go round this way, past Helgen, I think that's probably the quickest route. Otherwise, the other end of the way to go is this way, which leads us back into Dragon Country again, which I'm not particularly keen on doing. So, yeah, that looks like we're going to be going via Helgen, I think. That's my plan, anyway. Let's see what actually happens.
I can take you to any of the Hold capitals. Where do you want to go?
Whiterun.
Climb and back, and we'll be off. Couldn't ask for better weather.
I'm pretty sure I could, but, each to his own. The Companions trace their legacy back to the original 500 Companions of Iskrimor, who led the first humans to Skyrim, and eventually settled all of Tamriel. Would you believe it, Lydia? Would you believe it? Oh look, he's got his horses back at least. And the cart's back. Excellent. Everything's back to normal. Good. So, I'm currently hungry, thirsty, not tired, and so, oh, for heaven's sake. I don't have any food. I've got plenty of water. Get more water. Thirst has been quenched, right. That'll do for now. I'll find some food later. We'll run across something on our way. You know. On our way to Ivarstead, I'm sure. Probably a deer or something I can kill and then cook. Start a little fire up, get the cooking pot out, have some lunch. Yeah, it'd be lovely, Lydia. A picnic. Of the sort. So, yeah. off to High Hrothgar. Is that High Hrothgar up there? I mean, would you believe it? I don't think I've ever noticed that before now. I've got, what, 611 hours according to Steam on this game, and I never actually noticed you could see High Hrothgar from here. Huh. Well, anyway, that's where we're headed. I don't mind admitting, actually, the first time I played this game, first time I ever did the main quest, I was told to go to High Hrothgar, ignored my map markers completely, and decided to try and head directly to High Hrothgar. The fastest route I considered available to me, and it resulted, unfortunately, in me spending what must have been a good 2 hours trying various different routes manually up the side of the mountain to try and get to High Hrothgar instead of me actually going to Iverstead, because apparently my brain had completely forgotten that there was this whole 7,000 steps thing, which would necessarily entail that the correct way up the mountain would have steps on it, but no, I actually tried to go up there by literally trying to climb the mountain, and it ended in disaster, I'm afraid. I think I ended up getting killed by a Wisp Mother. It was very amusing, but there you go. I'd be playing too much Morrowind, I think, because of course in Morrowind you have Red Mountain, which is, you know, slap bang in the middle of the map, much in the same way that Throat of the World is, and Red Mountain isn't very easy navigatable, and you pretty much have to climb that thing and find your way up through trial and error, basically. It's not very easy terrain, and I assumed it would be a very similar case with High Hrothgar, but no. Smash. I'll tell you what, that almost feels like a waste using a magic weapon on wolves. I don't... Yes. Oh, no, hang on a minute. I still have my little short sword. So you know what, I'll use that for now on the random wildlife we encounter. I'll whip out the big Dwemer longsword when we actually encounter something worth using it on. Come on, Lydia. Keep up. Yes. So there you go, a little anecdote into my first forays into Skyrim. Yes, believe it or not, I was even more of a useless noob at this game than I am now at one point. Not so fast. I love how he's just standing there, paralyzed with shock. Oh, damn it. That's what you get for talking and not shooting, Jingles. Come back here. Oh dear. Submarine deer. There he is. Come on, you. Won't escape me that easily. Except, apparently he will. Damn it. Oh, you little. If I weren't completely out of stamina, I'd be after you right now. Oh Christ, Lydia's run after him. Lydia, come back. It's just a deer. Oh wait, it's dead. Did you kill it? Or did it bleed out? If you killed it, then well done. You just caught us our lunch. Yeah, why not? Still need to make that big fur tent, actually. Plus, I'll need pelts and things to make another backpack out of, so... Ugh, this longbow does look so daft when he's on his back like that. Longbow's not really something you're meant to carry around like that, I don't think. It's not one of those sort of weapons. It's a... Much like a two-handed sword, it's a battlefield weapon. And you're not really supposed to actually carry it around with you. You know, just every day using it to defend yourself in taverns, that kind of thing, really. So that's why I tend to shy away a bit from two-handed weapons in this game, just because in real life carrying a two-handed axe around with you or a two-handed sword is just terribly, terribly unrealistic. It's just you just couldn't do it. It's just silly. They weren't designed to be used like that, so. God, it's a pretty bit of Skyrim, isn't it, this area around? If he wasn't on the other side of the stream. It's a pretty bit of Skyrim, this kind of area here and around Falkreath. I like it a lot. Come on, then. Apparently wolves die really easily even on expert. Fine, fair enough. Oh god, so many people. So many people going, "Ooh, what are you whining about it being on expert for? You should play it on Master or Legendary." Need I remind you I am playing with Skyri installed and therefore the game is exponentially more difficult by default. It's recommended I play it on Adept and I'm currently playing it on Expert, so yeah, you know. Keep up, damn it. At least the pathfinding seems to be okay for now. In the older versions of Skyrim before it got patched, it was quite abysmal. Still pretty visible in all fairness, actually, now, but at least she's managing to walk in a straight line. I don't use followers very often. I'll make no secret of that. Aha, the Guardian Stones. I've not actually visited these yet, because I took a different route down from Helgen. It's the one Hadvar usually goes down. So, Thief, Wizard, Warrior. This one's pretty much a no-brainer, isn't it, Lydia? And those under the sign of the Warrior are a force to be reckoned with, honing combat skills to perfection 20% more quickly. Yes, please. Not that I really need it, but... Heh, I love these things, they're so cool. Interesting way of doing the whole star sign thing, although I personally... Personally, prefer still being able to pick your birth sign at the beginning of the game. You know, whole idea is that you're born under a certain sign, you know, and that's kind of that marks your date, destiny, or fate, or whatever. But there you go. On the whole, I definitely think most of the gameplay changes in Skyrim were for the better. I've been playing a lot of Morrowind recently, specifically the Blood Moon expansion. Because we're going to be doing Dragonborn at some point in this Let's Play, and I kind of wanted old Solstheim, if you want to call it that, still fresh in my mind when we eventually do Brit Dragonborn. So I've been playing that. And, oh god, let me tell you, going back to Morrowind from Skyrim, Jesus, that game is clunky. It really is. And, you know, God help you if you pick the wrong skill at the beginning of character creation and, like, 20 levels later you decide, ugh, you know what, why the hell did I pick Spear? I would have much rather have had Marksman. Yeah. Definitely prefer the way Skyrim does it. I'm probably in a minority on that, but, yeah, well, most of you probably know my opinions on dumbing down versus actual gameplay design changes. So anyway, that's it about the better. It's only going to cause a flame war in the comments anyway. And God knows we've had enough of those on this Let's Play so far. Helgen. There's lights on in the tower, interestingly enough. I wonder who's taken up residence. Do we want to find out who's taken up residence? Oh, well. It was a bit of a ghost town when we last saw. Oh. Oh dear. Doesn't look like we're in pleasant company here, does it, Lydia? Unlock gate print. Aha! Aha! Now then, finally. Finally, I get a chance to test out this lock bashing mechanic from lockpicking overhaul, so let's see if it works. Ah! Heck yes, it did work. I don't know how I managed to bash open that massive gate with this tiny sword, but it worked alright. Although before we go any further, that needs to be favorited. I don't know what bloody hotkey to put it on though. I'm running out of those pretty fast, so I'll just leave it off for now. Right. Ah. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. Broadsword of Scorching, go!
Okay.
right through the chest. You're right, Lydia. Yeah, she's fine. Why am I even asking? She slew a dragon. A bunch of bandits are not going to inconvenience her in the slightest. What's that? Warchief headdress. Heavy armor. Somehow don't think I'm gonna... Well, I don't know. Let's have a look at it. We shall never speak of this again. Now. Actually, you know what? Having said that, it did remind me when I put it on a bit of those, you know, the lion's head hats that Roman legionaries wore, you know, the standard bearers wore. That's what it instantly reminded me of, but no. No. Not a chance. Oh dear. Anyway, is there any more of them around here? Don't see any. My vision's going a bit blurry. Am I cold? Good grief, I'm freezing! I don't know how... Well, you're a Nord, aren't you, Lydia? So you're probably fine with the cold, but... I forgot. I completely forgot I even had, bloody well had Frostfall installed for a second there. Need to find a fire. Hopefully we can warm up next to these. Come on, warm me up. You feel chilly. I think that's an improvement over freezing bloody cold. Begin to warm up. Good, good, good. Nearly froze to death and didn't even know it. Could do with some notifications occasionally popping up, actually. I think that, you know what, they already do, don't they? And I'm just too much of a dunce to notice them. -7, +1, +1. I don't think it's going to go any higher than +1, is it? I feel warm, apparently. +9, oh, that's okay. That'll do. +9 will do. Right, come on, Lydia, let's go. I said, come on, Lydia, let's go. That dragon knock you over the head in one of the ears or something. You half blind, is that it? Is that gonna be your excuse from now on anyway? Back to this for now, I think. Any more bandits around? Don't see any. That's never gonna get old. Oh, such a good idea installing that mod. Thank you to everyone who recommended it to me. Really. Such a cracking good idea. Anyway. Because it completely removes like the normal lockpicking minigame completely from the game. It's just just completely gone. Like, when you're actually lockpicking using a lock, you know, like a lockpick, it becomes more like, you know, Morrowind style of lockpicking, where it's based purely on percentage chances based on your skill and that kind of thing, which I love. It's much better. And there's actually a point to having lockpicking skill, otherwise in the vanilla game there just isn't, because you can pick any lock at any level. And I'm going to mine this iron ore. So yeah, I approve of that. I've decided going to install an ultimate follower overhaul, because that's pretty much what everyone's suggesting in the comments, and I've used it before anyway myself, so like I said, I'm not entirely sure why I didn't reinstall it when I reinstalled Skyrim. So there it is. I'm going to definitely get that again, which will allow me to customize, well, Lydia a bit, make her non-essential and that sort of thing. And oh, bless, she put a little hood on because she's cold. Finally cold. I've been freezing for the last half an hour, Lydia. It's a bit uneventful, this, isn't it, really, actually? Not that I mind, it gives me a chance to waffle on incoherently without being interrupted by anything. It's just a rock. I thought it was a bear. Ugh. But, yeah. Bit eventful, really. Not that, yeah, not, like I said, not that I mind, though. Because I'll say that, won't I? And then a dragon will appear overhead and we'll have to go through all that palaver again. But I tell you what, though. I can tell I've been playing too much Morrowind lately when... I instantly get the urge to stop running and walk. Because obviously in Morrowind, you have to occasionally do that, because otherwise running in Morrowind, basically, for those who haven't played it, drains your stamina. And if you've got low stamina, you suck in combat. So you get the urge to stop running. So, what have we got here? A camp full of Stormcloaks? And yeah, my vision's being obscured because there's a blizzard. That's what that blinking is there, in case you were wondering. Oh! And also, I think, I don't know, we've not really had a chance to demonstrate this yet, but as you can see, we are covered in snow! Because of wet and cold. We've literally got snow covered all over us. We look very, very chilly indeed. Yeah, in fact, according to the game, I do feel chilly. This is not good, right? Well, we can't very well leave them here, can we? Now, apparently... Oh, nice. Apparently, wet and cold actually makes it so that you're more difficult to detect by enemies when you're in the middle of a blizzard. Which is awesome. I've been detected. And no one seems bothered. So that's fine. Hello, Stormcloak soldier. Oh, he had a crossbow. Good thing I did take him out. Because now I've got some extra bolts and rabbit haunch. Lovely. Where's his friend? Also had crossbow bolts. And I have 72 of these bloody things. Finally! I actually have some ammunition. Gosh, I'm moving slowly. It's because I'm cold, isn't it? And because I'm in the middle of a blizzard as well. That also reduces your speed, I believe. Okay. Pretty close. Fulgrith Stormcloak camp discovered.
You're trespassing here. You better clear out.
Oh, crap. They've spotted us, Lydia.
This is your last warning. Get away from
me. Right. Oops. Missed. Sorry. Right. Wrong bloody weapon, but never mind. Seems to have done the job. Oh, is this guy essential? Oh, I thought the unofficial patch fixed that. That's going to be very irritating. Aha! Fire damage! You know, like fire damage. Do you, Mr. Nord? I'm crying out loud. You should be dead! I had a mini mod installed which makes those generals, guys, those little officers, killable. And then Boss told me that, Boss, by which I mean the Better Oblivion sorting software, told me that that fix was already included in the unofficial patch, which I have running, so I feel cheated, frankly. You know what? Right, I have... I just quit out the game and re-enabled the Kill Them Generals fix. So I can kill this bastard. Because that was really annoying me, that was.
This is your last warning. Get away from there,
or else what? Or else I'm going to shoot you in the face with a crossbow. That's what. Take that for it, sun killer. Oh, get this. I am... Oh, God, my health. Being shot at by like 12 people all at once. This is not good. Whoops! I just foosed Lydia. Whoops! Didn't mean to do that, sorry. Oh, for heaven's sake. Fine. Apparently that hasn't worked either. Damn it. You You little bastard. I am... You know what? You're dead. You are dead. And you're gone. Be gone. You're dead. I'm not having that. Apparently that reinstalling that fix didn't work. Steel short spear. Short spears deal reduced damage against armored enemies. So why would you want one? Other than the fact that they look kind of cool. But... yeah. Steel arrows, though. Alright. Good work, Lydia. They didn't know what hit them. We got for... oh, hang on a minute. Maybe a cloak for Lydia. Yeah, you want this?
Still here. How can I serve you, my thane?
Where is it? There you go. Enjoy.
Let's get going, then.
Oh god, bloody hell, it's freezing. Warm up. Quickly, please. Warm, warm, warm. Hopefully this should work, because we're inside a tent. And therefore it counts as sheltered heat, or whatever. I hope, anyway. Can we please warm up now? Please. Pretty please. Oh god, this isn't working. Help! I want to warm up. Oh god, your shelter keeps you from getting any colder. Yeah, I've got shelter, but why won't you let me blast well warm up? Oh, this is annoying as balls. Right, I'm gonna go to the campfire. Apparently that brazier thing doesn't count as warming us up. Right. Now warm me, please. Before I blooming freeze to death. Minus 49, okay, it's having an effect, I think. That shall trap the warmth, the heat is Alfred. Sorry. Do I have to light a blasted fire inside the damn tent for this to work, or what? Can I go in here? Do I have enough firewood? I do, don't I, for another fire. I guess we're going to have to light one, Lydia, otherwise we're literally going to die. Because apparently, even though this camp setup was good enough for this... Will you seriously move, woman?
Be careful.
Yeah, out of the way. Apparently this camp setup was good enough for the Stormcloaks, but not good enough for Frostfall. Annoyingly. Let's try this again. Minus 47. Alright, alright, okay. Minus 40, oh, for heaven's sake. I know I can do. I don't have to light a campfire. I can do something else instead. Where is my tent? Pitch the tent. But not on top of the campfire. That wouldn't be very clever. Should pitch my tent here, damn it. And why is it blue and yellow? That's a little... Oh, nothing is working today, is it? Right, I shall pitch my tent here. Excellent. And I shall sit in my tent. There we go. And oh, it's got a bit funny, hasn't it? There we go. You feel chilly. Use lantern, I guess. Why not? Now can I warm up, please? Exposure 39. Brilliant, it's working. I don't know why he took his boots off. I'd leave him on if I were him. This is... Times like this that Frostfall starts to get a little silly. But never mind. You feel comfortable. Good. Now, that said, we did insist on walking into the mountains in the middle of a blizzard. So there is that, I guess. In hindsight, it wasn't terribly smart, but whatever. You feel warm, finally. Right, that will do. Get up. Pack up. Good. Right, let's go. Come on, before we freeze to death. Oh, there are horses. I don't like horses, but this might be a sound plan, Lydia. What do you think? Are you going to get on that horse? No, you're not going to do that, are you? I don't have any mods installed for that. Oh, screw it. Let's just go. If she was able to jump on the other horse, we could and then have us both gallop off towards Iverstead. That would be awesome, but since we can't... Oh, Lydia, for heaven's sake. Well, every minute you muck about with your pathfinding, I get closer to dying. The hell is she? There she is. Right, come on, let's go. Let's move! I've completely lost track of time now. In terms of how long I've been recording for, I'll probably just have to put another random split with a to be continued in order to keep this going. Never mind. I doubt anyone really cares, so I suppose it doesn't matter. Oh, I hate mountains. And snow. What the... Are you... Yeah, you're just... You're a hunter. Good. You just gratuitously murdered that fox. Okay. I think I still have those furs, but I don't want to switch into them. I've got this armor. Yeah, someone said I should probably switch the Imperial armor to full protection instead of standard because, well, because I do have that mod that modifies it to look like it's more suited to cold weather. And you know what? You might be right. Probably does sound like a good idea. I might do it right now, actually. If I can remember what the button is, there we go. Inspect equipment. Equip the piece you wish to inspect now. I'll do it just for the main bit of Imperial armor, and I'll leave it for the rest of the, you know, the boots and the gauntlets and all that kind of stuff. Just gotta can't be bothered to do those, and they don't look like they provide a great deal of exposure protection anyway, do they? So it's the actual main piece of armor that we're talking about here, and a random horse. Very nice. God, this is like, yeah, this is like Gandalf. We must turn back. The hobbits will die. Weather, and tell me that wasn't what I think it was. It was, wasn't it? There was me, sitting there thinking, oh, I don't want to go into dragon country. Don't want to have to face a dragon. Oh, dear. Lydia, can you please not, aggro the dragon, please? I'd rather you didn't antagonize giant fire, frost, or lightning-breathing lizards. I'm sure you're fairly confident in your ability to kill them. Well, I'm not confident in my ability to survive the onslaught. So, let's not do that, shall we? I don't even know where the damn thing is. I didn't see it. I just heard it, so... He hasn't made any more noises, so maybe we're safe, but... Of course, it's when you assume you're safe and you get up and start running again that you see the giant dragon shadow swoop across the bottom of the screen. So, however, the longer we take to get through here, the more likely I am to freeze. Which would not be good. And believe me, you can die of exposure with Frostfall. I nearly managed it once myself with a different character when I was testing the mod out. It wasn't pretty. Okay, I can see some orangey trees. I think we're on the right track. No sign of dragon either, which is also good news. Yeah, I think we're probably safe for now. I don't see him anywhere, not even flying around above. He sounded bloody close though, didn't he? Anyway. Oh, thank goodness. The blizzard has ended. Just in time for us to kill some more wolves. Is that it? Apparently that's it. Okay then. Right, yeah, come on, the blizzard, stop now, game. You can stop doing the silly blinding effects. I think I can switch those off, actually. In the effect of... Hang on a minute. Are those stark? What? Good grief, it's eight. It's quarter to nine. Lydia, that journey took longer than I thought it would. Uh-oh. Oh, it's a blasted elk. I thought it was someone on horseback. Deary me. I think the blizzard has screwed with my senses. Anyway, what's the temperature like now? The air is cold. Well, that's better than bone chilling, I suppose, isn't it? Come on, Lydia. We've already seen a lot of night skies so far in this last play, which is a shame. Damn shame, because the night skies in this game are rather nice. Blimey, these things are tough. Oh, of course you just one-shot it. Wonderful. Show off. I'm a little bit worried now, actually, because... I think once we hit 9 o'clock, the nighttime spawns from immersive creatures will start appearing. And that's a bear I can hear over there, let's leave it alone. And the nighttime spawns from immersive creatures are, well, needless to say, kind of unpleasant. So, the sooner we get to Ibistead, the better, but oh, look at that sky! Look at it! It's lovely! Anyway. Right, well, since we've got a home stretch of road, not much to talk about. Hungry, slightly thirsty. Oh, I'm slightly thirsty. Well, we can do something about that. At least. Anyway, so, okay, lots of people have been asking me, and I'm hesitant to even answer this, because I know it's going to cause one colossal flame war in the comments, but never mind. People have been asking me, what do I personally think of the Stormcloaks and Ulfric Stormcloak? Because they all know what Claudius' opinion of him is, but what is my opinion, personally, as a player? And, well, you're not going to like this, Stormcloak fans, but I don't like the Stormcloaks, personally, very much. Of course, ironically, I've had more characters that have sided with the Stormcloaks in this game than haven't. Actually, my first character I played in Skyrim was a Stormcloak, actually, so there you go. But I don't really like the Stormcloaks. Specifically, I don't like Ulfric Stormcloak. Because, and it's dangerous territory I'm walking around on right now, but basically, there's something I just really don't like about Ulfric. I mean, he's a great character and all. He's a great character, and he's very well voice acted by Vladimir Kulic, who's brilliant, by the way. He was in the 13th Warrior, and he's awesome. But the thing is, I'm going to go inside and warm up. That's what's happening. Thing is, and well, how do I approach this in a way that isn't going to sound daft?
You want a drink?
No, actually, but I could do with some food.
Depends. Are you thirsty? Hungry? Both?
Rather hungry, actually. Apple cabbage stew sounds good to beef stew. Yes. Beef stew. Thank you. Anyway, so...
A pleasant journey, my lord.
Take your hat off when you come inside, Claudius. It's rude not to. And, yeah. stop the going for a piss in the corner pose. It's not very good. You can have another pose if you want. There we go. So anyway, while Claudius is warming up, the thing that gets me about Ulfric Stormcloak is the fact that he really, really, and there's no other way for me to say this without... Anyway, yeah, Stormcloak fans are going to hate me for this, but there's something about Ulfric Stormcloak that kind of reminds me a bit of Hitler. There, I said it. He really does. Not because, well, he's racist and that kind of thing, but, you know, even though there's a little bit of evidence to support the fact that Ulfric is slightly racist, but... that's kind of besides the point really, in terms of what I'm talking about. The thing is, you've got... you've got this country, Skyrim, which is, funnily enough, in the lore, occasionally referred to as the Fatherland. Check the, you know, the first edition Pocket Guide to the Empire, if you don't believe me. I think it's like even on some of the loading screens in this game. It's occasionally referred to as the Fatherland, believe it or not. And you have this war between humans and elves, and the Empire, for all intents and purposes, kind of loses, and it has this horrible treaty enforced on it in the form of the White Gold Concordat. And you have this demagogue with a questionable background in Skyrim who is using this treaty and the terms of this treaty specifically to drum up support for his own rise to power. And are you seeing the uncomfortable parallels here, guys? Yeah, because I am, and I'm quite sure they were deliberate on Bethesda's part, by the way. But yeah, I mean, for those of you who really need it spelled out, well, the White Gold Concordat is very much Tamriel's version of the Treaty of Versailles, and Ulfric, I feel, bears an uncanny resemblance to Adolf Hitler. There you go, I said it. That's why I don't like the Stormcloaks, personally. They make me feel a little bit uncomfortable, because it's just too easy to make those kind of parallels. It's way too easy. It's so easy that it cannot have possibly escaped Bethesda's attention while they were designing the Stormcloaks, and therefore I feel it was kind of intentional on their part to leave that in there, and that's what makes me kind of a bit meh about them. So there you go. But anyway, I'm going to get tons of horrible comments about that. I can already tell. By the time I've even said this sentence, there have probably been 10 posted explaining to me in wondrous detail, paragraphs and paragraphs, explaining to me why I am wrong and why the lore does not support anything that I have said, and there you go. But anyway, I just don't care, frankly. People ask me what my opinion was, and I've given it, so... what about this barrow? Sorry?
There ain't much more to tell. They're haunted, and you should stay away. Look, I've seen one of the spirits with my very own eyes. When it glared at me, I swear it burned right through my soul.
What? Really? Well, you know what? There was a time when I wouldn't have believed a word of that, but considering what's happened over the last couple of weeks, sure, yeah, there are ghosts haunting a barrow next to your town. What else is new?
Fortunately, they seem to be sticking to the barrow. I think they're guarding it. Certainly isn't helping my business any. Who'd want to rent a room anywhere near a haunted barrow?
Students. Like, students. They love to rent a room near a haunted barrow. Just, you know, put a few flyers in the local university paper or something like that. Go for it. It'll work. Trust me. Anyway, could I investigate for him? Not sure I want to, really. I've kind of got things to do, but... I can't help you at the minute, mate. Sorry.
Don't blame you one bit.
Fair enough, then. So, anything you can tell me about Hrothgar, sorry. Working on my Nordic pronunciations, Wilhelm. You'll have to forgive me, I'm new to this place.
Drink for the thirsty, food for the hungry.
Have I ever mentioned how much I hate the dialogue interface in this game? Right, can I just... There we go. Easy to do with the arrow keys.
I don't think they've ever ventured outside their monastery. We get the occasional pilgrim passing through here on their way to the summit. But almost all of them have returned disappointed.
Okay, so they're recluses, basically. God, do you see, that's so annoying the way it does that. Like, you get the highlighted thing gets stuck regardless of what you mouse over. Very annoying. Anyway.
If you pass through again, stop by for a drink.
Yeah, we'll do. Yes, sit down. Feel free to sit down as well. If you want to, Lydia. Guess not. Beef stew. Thank you very much. You could have a bit more. Rabbit haunch. Apparently I'm still not sated. I'll have to get some more food in a minute. Who are you? I've not seen you around here before. You must be an interesting NPC. Let's try to make a bit of... conversation with him or something, I don't know. What do you think of Iverstead, then?
There are many rumors here in Iverstead of ghosts and haunted barrels. Daraki wonders what is the real danger, the spirits or the gossip?
Any other conspiracies you've unraveled?
Daraki has heard that the Thum is the language of dragons. What if the shout heard from Higher Algar was not made by man? It may be a clever trap set by the World Eater himself. The Dragonborn would do well to keep this in mind.
The world who? Anyway, what's on your mind?
Daraki is wondering if the Greybeards even exist. No one has ever seen them, not even Klimik. Perhaps his packages are taken by the rats.
Fair enough, I suppose. I'm pretty sure they'd exist, though, if there's all this hullabaloo about them, but, well, anyway.
Bah, you make Daraki lose count. You must not interrupt him when he walks the steps in his mind.
Excuse me?
Yes, perhaps you can. There is something foul afoot, Fred. Daraki can smell the stench of betrayal in the air.
I like some of the dialogue responses in this mod. I don't smell anything.
Your nose is not attuned to deceit. Daraki smells the lie, but he cannot confirm it. To some, an unconfirmed lie is the same as the truth. But Daraki is not the kind to agree on something simply on faith.
Still not following you? No, I'm not either, viewers.
Daraki talks of the steps to High Hrothgar. Many travelers come to walk the pilgrimage of the 7,000 steps, yet Daraki finds that number peculiar. Do you not find it odd that the number is so round? Was the path altered to match the myth? Are the steps not all the same size? I have found it difficult to believe, based on my calculations, that there can be any more than 6,972 steps.
Okay, fair enough. I just don't see what the big deal is. It's a lot of steps, so what, they called it 7,000 because they were rounding up. What's the big deal?
It is a matter of integrity. If they are lying about these steps, who knows what else they are hiding? Lies and secrets are fine for tavern wenches, but the Greybeards are said to be the paragons of virtue. If the best of us can be corrupted, then there is no hope for Daraki to ever trust anyone.
Right, you've convinced me. I'll count them.
Really? This is most fortuitous. I had almost given up all hope, but do not rush. Take your time and return when you have an answer.
Nice, that's an actual quest. I can't believe this. This is count the steps, really. Still, I thought I was just being sarcastic. Oh, man. Stuff of legends. Count the steps. It's probably only going to be like 700 rather than 7,000, isn't there? Oh, good grief. You know what, Lydia? You can count the steps for me. I'm going to bed.
I think I saw it again.
As soon as I hire a room, of course. It was over
by the barrel. Sure thing. It's yours for a day. I'll show you to your room. Right this way.
This way? Ah.
Let me know if there's anything else you need.
Oh, you even got a bed for Lydia. That's very considerate of you. You gave us the two-bedroom. Awesome. Well, you, that's yours. This one, this is mine. Because I got the extra wolf blanket. So there.